It's the Daily Dog.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to another edition of the Daily Dog. It's Dr. Doug here with you. We're breaking down another song, and we're at the piano by request. So thanks to everybody for saying that you like this particular approach as we do this. I still will do most of my reactions from my office, but occasionally when I have the opportunity, I'll pop over here and sort of take you through these songs as I am able to as we hear them. So the last time I was over here, we were doing a Porcupine Tree song, and it was called Trains, and I was talking about my respect for Steven Wilson as a musician, as a recording engineer, and my brother was talking to me last night, and he says, so if you're on a Steven Wilson kick, go back to Opeth on an album where he engineered it and helped them out with it. And he suggested Harvest off of the album Blackwater Park. So that's what I'm going to be doing today, and I'm listening to their studio recording. I've got the computer here so I can stop and start, and we'll see if we can break this song down and figure out what they're doing with it musically. I did look through the lyrics, and they're quite ingenious and powerful. To me, it's a metaphor. He's talking about the harvesting of his own life or his own soul, or maybe a soul. It's written from like first person perspective. And I think he's nearing the end of his life, and he's talking about becoming a martyr and the people that are left behind. It sounds really interesting to me, or it reads very interesting, so I'm curious to see what they did to set that particular text. And let us wait no longer. Here we go. Blackwater Park is the album, Harvest is the song, and this is Opeth. Here we go. Y'all are pros at this by now. Can you tell what key we're in? That sounds like E minor. E minor is also seemingly a good choice for prog bands. They seem to like E a lot. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, it goes. Over E. It's a neat sound. Nice intro, well mixed, sounds great. Oh, they're gonna stay in compound meter. That rhythm made me feel like they were breaking into 4/4. Cool. New key. First time we've heard voices too. Rise above the vile. C minor. Yeah. It's 1 and 5 in C. Sounds so cool. It's in a new key. New stuff. Again, I think they moved to. Yeah, A minor. E minor. Okay. E minor. A minor. Yeah. Yeah, A flat. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so what I can gather so far, if I can remember all this, they started off in E minor. Right? And then they got to C minor. Right? Down 1 to 5. And then they went from there, that G chord that they landed on is 5 to C, but it's also subtonic to A minor, right? C's relative minor if we were in C major, right? But we went from C minor to A. So we went from E, actually, E down to C, down to A. Descending thirds is where they're moving. It's kind of a trinity of modulations. That's kind of cool. So by the time they ended up in that A chord, in A minor, they ended up on a weird A flat chord, and that gets them back into a sound that's almost like, sorry about that, my computer dinged. That's like, that's really close to in the key of C minor, and then we end up back up in C. So let's see how this keeps going. I'm gonna back up a little bit. Yeah. So this is a verse, I think. Y'all help me out here. So this section's in C minor. Now that G becomes, if I do it again, up to A, down to E, minor 5, then up to B minor, G, F sharp major, that's weird, back to A minor. A flat chord gets them back into C. Except they're not in C. They went into D minor. And that is a weird progression. Is the weirdest chord progression. It works though. So here's what I hear. For this solo, they went into D, right? So it sounds like a D chord to A minor, and then it's A flat major, B minor, G minor, is what it sounds like to me. At least that's what the bass notes are doing. I think the chords are right. That's a weird progression. Let's back up and see a little bit of how they're doing this. Yeah. That's a D, A flat, B, G. Weird. I like it though. The fact that it's different, that's not a traditional chord progression that you hear in regular bubblegum pop music or even like standard classical repertoire. Back where they were previously in C minor. It's really smart. And then went back to E minor. That's cool. It's really smart how they get from C minor to A minor. They use the G major chord as sort of a dominant in one key and subtonic in another, and then they're back to this E minor. I really like this. It's like an outro, it's similar to the beginning. Cool. The whole song? I think that's it. Wow, y'all. So, let's see. If I was to try to remember this. So this is something that we do in music school. Like, I remember that they would, we do formal listening tests and we practice this stuff. Like, I would put on a sonata movement or just a movement of a cantata or a symphony or whatever, you know, like a 3, 4, or 5 minute piece, maybe even longer, and ask the students to come up with the form of the piece and key areas just as they listen. So that's kind of what I was doing here. It's not magic, it's just stuff that we train and practice at doing. So it's my point is it's a cultivatable skill. They started off in E minor for the intro, and then right? And then that went to what I'll call a verse in C minor. Da dee 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 dum, dum dum dee da dee, and so on, right? And then that G major should be dominant to C, but it's also subtonic to A. And that's how they get to A minor for, I guess, is a different type of verse or a chorus. So A minor to E minor to, where did they go? B minor to G to F sharp, I think is what they were doing. And then to go from an F sharp chord to an A minor chord, to go back to start that, is something that you won't see a whole lot of in classical music. But when you're not versed well in classical music, who cares? You're writing your own music, right? So that's what I'm really finding that I love about listening to these other bands, is these folks who haven't been sort of trapped in higher education, this is how music is supposed to work, are just using their own creativity and going, why don't I go from this chord to that chord to this chord? Fuck it, it sounds good. So that's what we're gonna do. It kind of opens me up to kind of get my head out of my ass a little bit about what all I've been taught about the way serious music should be written. This music that I've been listening to from these bands, some of it is kind of eh, but a lot of it is extremely well crafted and very innovative and creative and quite interesting. The thing that drives me away sometimes is when everything gets to be so loud or so overbearing that you can't hear all of the nuance that's inherently embedded in the music. And that's why I've gravitated towards some of what Stephen Wilson has been doing, because I find his recordings to be utterly listenable and enjoyable, because I can hear all of the nuance and the craft that goes into making these particular songs. It's really cool. The thing that was happening in the middle, that one middle section, went to D all of a sudden. I don't think I'm going to be able to remember. Maybe I can. It was a D minor chord, then an A minor chord, and then an A flat and a B minor and a G minor chord. Those have no business being in the same phrase, traditionally. A minor, no sharps or flats. No, sorry, D minor works. A minor is in D minor, but then to go to A flat, that's something that Steve Wilson did in The Raven That Refused to Sing, is to go back and forth between A minor and A flat. You can do that with the C in the middle. The C is in both of those chords. The C is the third of the A minor chord, and the C is the third of the A flat major chord. So they went D, A minor, A flat to B minor to G minor before going back to D in that middle section. I need to listen to it again. But I am enthralled by this, and I took it away. I look back at it like it's still there. crazy stuff. So, well, that was fun. What do you guys think? That was one of the, I think, the first Opeth song that I've ever heard where he isn't using some of his growls for all of it or some of it. It's my favorite Opeth song that I've heard so far. That had some really neat stuff in it. Great progressions, lovely sound, and of course, it's mixed perfectly well. So, cool. Well, this was fun. I'll keep doing these as I am able, and I appreciate you guys continuing to tune in and listen to me rant and rave and try to figure these things out as we go. I am listening more in the background as well, so just enjoying getting used to and learning some new repertoire. So thanks for being with me, and we will see you next time on The Daily Duck.